I'm only 20 years old. I'll be 21 in October. So I don't have the same experience. I haven't seen the world the same way as you guys have, or and even here, these are young men right here. I brought these two with me. I wanted them to see them. I wanted them. And I'm sure these are young boys that are waiting to become men. We have to show them these are the things that you do. So, like I said, I'm ready to start working whenever all of you guys are. I'm ready to start working right now, honestly, because I can't take hearing every other day someone's getting shot for trying to de-escalate a situation. Or another senseless killing. I don't think my heart can take it. And
long overdue. You're the future. All these are the future. These are my boys right here. And it's long overdue. We can't lose no one else. And one thing that kind of sparked me to get this going was, and I know this brother here can attest to what I'm saying, and I hope we don't bring up any bad memories. But all this killing that's been starting, to me, with my memory, kind of started with one of his good friends, Lamin. Right? And then a couple years after that, my cousin got killed right up on Pine Street, Garrett Fisher, over a girl. The same day I converted to Islam, if the mosque is not there anymore, right there, a brother by the name of Billy Walker knocked on the mosque door while I was converting to Islam. He said, your brother's real cousin was murdered up on Pine Street. He's Garrett Fisher. You all remember him? Yeah, that's my first cousin. His mom and my mom are sisters.
My cousin Shannon, Shannon and Sean, the twins, I don't know if any of you guys know them. He was killed. So my dad, he just recently started going back on that street. So my family has experienced loss. My cousin Rashad Barnes, about 15 years ago, was killed by a police officer. So knowing all that, and knowing that I couldn't do anything about it, and now I have an opportunity to do something about it today. This means a lot to me. All of you guys coming here.
What's your name?
I'm Jade. I'm just blessed enough. I have five brothers growing up, and I'm the only girl. I do have a sister, but as far as like in the household, and all my brothers really did something with themselves. So, and also my father. So what I know as men is like a strong man that raising a family. All my brothers went to the military. They wasn't, here and there on the streets, but they didn't get too far where they couldn't do something with themselves. So it does, to me, it like seeing this, it hurts. Like it is my family, because we are honest. But time and time again, I keep every corner seeing balloons, teddy bears, and candles. And, I'm like, this is out of hand. Like every single corner, it's like, what is going on? I'm driving home just from like my job at the hospital. Boom here, boom there, boom there. It's just gotten way out of hand, and then definitely my boy Boots. It's still, even just saying his name, it still hurts so hard. Like I just can't believe the double standard that happened. But I'm just here today to say we can be as one. You just gotta put your mind to it, and also just be here. Just try to talk to you as much as possible. I know I do. Sometimes they look at me like you're crazy, but I do. I'm like, you don't gotta do that, brother. You can stand up and be a leader. You don't have to follow these other people. But I just want to give I shade from all of the young men that has passed away. Some of them I don't even know their names.
Sure.
Okay. Anyone else? Because I want to end out doing the real work. And you see, I got my brothers behind me. I don't ever come alone. So we want to hit the streets. We want to take a little walk. But walk. Lock on, I think it's powerful. We got some females, sisters here. So sisters, I don't want you in the front, and I don't want you in the back. I want you in the middle, and a brother on this side, and a brother on that side, to let you know we are protecting you. I apologize on all brothers who are willing to do it and not willing to do it for not protecting you and making you feel safe. Because I just came back here to Europe and I got grown men telling me they don't feel safe. So if grown men say they don't feel safe, I can only imagine how the women and the children feel. So this is what this is about. It's not a show. I'm for real. I want to go to all points of town and hopefully this will grow. And go and speak to the brothers and sisters. And they will tell you, this ain't about religion. If anyone knows me, their leader, those brothers there, their leader is Minister Farrakhan, like him or not. This Elijah Muhammad's son spoke last week and about brought tears in my eyes. He said the solution to the violence is not protesting, not necessarily jobs. It's a lack of knowledge of self and love for self, because you ain't going to hurt your brother if you love yourself. So that's really what the answer is. So that's the purpose, is to go out and let these brothers know. Young brothers like this, we love you, and we have a future. But we got to instill love in them. They don't love themselves, or else they wouldn't be so reckless towards someone else, even with words. And the sisters too, as much as the brother. So if y'all are with it, I want to just take a little walk that way, right? And anyone you see, give them. I got more help coming. It isn't nothing strictly. Just give them a hug. You know what I mean? Let them know that we hear from them. Just them seeing all of us together is going to be mind blowing. I'm like, what is this? Right? That's all we want to do is just walk up that way. I got water. We got water. If anyone needs any help, we're here for you.
You got more water?
Huh?
Yeah. It out.
Got more water. So we're gonna start walking up that way and maybe stop, you know, a little midway up the block, and then we'll circle back. But we're gonna lock arms, we're gonna be together. Ain't nothing gonna happen because God is with us. And I got my brothers with me. And the sisters, y'all gotta be in the middle. Brother on this side, brother on that side, because we got you. Y'all have been unprotected for too long. And we apologize for that. And the men that don't got, you know what to say, I apologize for you. Y'all should not feel not safe. The brothers shouldn't not feel safe. So this is what this is about. Everyone straight? So we're going to start walking that way, and we're just going to spread love.
Get out of here, man. Hey, be in touch. Next Monday, I got you.
All right. So,
What's up, bitch? Okay, dude. Man, why are you talking?
Not you. Still have your phone, too. I'm not sure you want to keep going.
Stop.